You're watching the NCAA Baseball Regionals presented by Capital One. Time for the headliner matchup here between NC State and Army. Game two, the Raleigh Regional live on ESPN3. In game one today, Auburn, very impressive. 17 hits, couple of three-run homers, defeating Northeastern easily, 13-4, and awaits the winner of tonight's second game. Greetings, welcome back to the Raleigh Regional. Jim Barber and Troy Eklund, the All-American from Arkansas. Well, we've got small ball of Army versus big ball of NC State. And how can a team that has nine collective homers all season long compete with NC State?
Well, they've got to do the little things well, and they've got a lot of team speed. And the nation's leading base stealer in Jacob Hurtubise with 46 stolen bases. Army got to this outing right here by winning the Patriot League tournament. So that's how they got here. Very good baseball team. Again, do the little things right.
Good hitter in John Rosenhoff, who Rosenhoff is 351 for the season. And for NC State, first time hosting in a while, but the sixth time overall in about 12 years, which makes them a pretty regular team for this basis.
Yeah, a team that's got five guys with double-digit home runs and led by the electric player, their shortstop, all ACC Will Wilson. He's a guy that has tremendous range at shortstop. He's hitting over 300, 14 home runs, and 50 RBIs.
Will Wilson in separate occasions this year with four hits five different times. NC State, 40-16. Army, 36-22. Starting lineups. First pitch next. Big right-hander for the Wolfpack is this man, Reed Johnston, 6'2", 195. Just a freshman, and so far, Troy, unbeaten on the season.
Yeah, he's a guy that really has solidified this pitching staff for the Wolfpack. You'll see Johnston go 90-92 with that fastball, and he really pitches off that fastball. A good slider, he'll mix in a change, but a guy that can really hit his spots when he's on.
He will face Jacob Hurtubise and the rest of the Army Black Knights lineup, and Hurtubise is a handful. If he gets on base, watch out. He already has 40 steals in 46 attempts. Then John Rosenhoff, the team's top hitter, 351, followed by Josh White. Anthony hits fourth, then Trey Martin, Matt Hudgens, Drake Titus, seventh. John McKenna, eighth, and Anthony Crompton will bat ninth. And Anthony Jakeen in that fourth spot at 293, also a dangerous hitter for the Army. Gorgeous night for baseball, even though the heat index has reached 96. Huge crowd tonight. They're up on the hill, and they have arrived early. So here's the table setter for Army. He must get on for them to have a chance. Strike one. Ken Lankford behind home plate. Morris Hodges umpiring at first. Mike Jarbo at second. Grady Smith, the third base umpire. Bunt down the first baseline. Going to be a tough play. Throw to first in time. Well done by Evan Edwards to JT Jarrett coming over to cover. And there is one out.
Nice bump by Hurtubise right there. You thought that's going to get out there in no man's land. You can see nice play, but with the first baseman, Edwards, being left-handed, I don't think he makes that play if he's a right-handed first baseman.
Really?
He has to throw behind the runner, so much easier throw being left-handed.
Army's only 300 or better hitter is John Rosenhoff, batting in the second position. At 351 this year, Troy has the most hits on the team with 71. And he is also a graduate, second lieutenant, one of two on this team.
That's just pretty cool when you can say something like that. These guys have got a lot more going on than just baseball.
Scorches one down the right field line and foul.
Just a loud strike right there by Rosenhoff. You can see he's got a really nice swing and really gets that bat barrel head through the hitting zone in a hurry.
Lots of family and friends here because he is from the Durham, North Carolina area, close to here. Takes the 1-1 pitch inside. John making his 105th career start. Two-one bounce toward first base. Pitcher to cover. They won't need him. Fielded nicely by Evan Edwards. Two outs.
Good start by the freshman, Reed Johnston. Letting his defense work behind him, but getting in on the hands of Rozoff. Kind of sawed him off right there. Just an easy ground ball for the first baseman, Edwards.
Which brings Josh White to the plate. 294 hitter. He has six triples. He's the second baseman. Batting in the third spot. Should be a man close to your heart because of all the triples you put together at Arkansas. Part of teams that went to two College World Series in Omaha.
Thank you, sir. But that, I tell you what, it's an amazing experience when you get the opportunity to play in Omaha. They roll out the red carpet for you.
And Florida, defending champion, rolled over Columbia today. Odds on favor to get to the Super Regionals in Gainesville and then on to Omaha for the second year in a row and trying to repeat. Headed toward right field, cut off by Edwards. Pitcher covering. Can he get there? No! Be a base hit for Josh White, who is flying down that first base line.
Well, you can see the speed of Army. All three of these plays have been pretty close at first base. Just kind of an excuse me swing out there by White, but hustling down the first base line, and well, it's a bang bang play. No replays in any regional out here. Supers are going to have some replays. NCAA has had none for the regular regionals.
Yeah, you would hope that changes because people are really getting used to and spoiled in some ways by replay. This towards center field. McLean will get it. Two-out single by Army wasted. North Carolina State will send up the ACC's top hitter, Josh McLean, in the bottom of the first. For the Knights of Army on the mound, the left-handed thrower Tyler Giovinco, a career ERA of 4.49.
Yeah, he's definitely going to have to keep the ball down against this Wolfpack lineup. Like we mentioned in the open, five guys with double-digit home runs, and that's almost unheard of at the college level. Giovinco is going to be 85 to 87 with that fastball. He'll throw a slider, and then, which is his best pitch. And he might start off some guys with a slow curveball early on in a count, kind of that get-me-over curve early on. So let's see if the Wolfpack might be sitting on that.
Got to keep number 15 off the bases. The leadoff hitter, Josh McLean, 337. Then Kinnaman, Wilson, Bailey, and Dethridge, Edwards, Conley, Stephen Patera, and JT Jarrett. Winds out the North Carolina State lineup. Again, a record of 40-16. McLean tops in the ACC with 86 hits and a career batting average of 310.
That's ridiculous. That's amazing when you're talking about a career. You can see about think about doing it for a season, but over a career.
Just seems to be getting better every year. Inside fastball called strike one and two. It's a big inning for Army.
I think it's kind of a tone setter for them.
You saw in the earlier game where Auburn jumped out 3-0 and never really got threatened. And it's getting through that first inning of jitters and the fact that you want to feel like you're not overmatched by the one seed and also 16 seeded nationally, NC State Wolfpack. Count runs full.
But the thing about this NC State lineup, you look at it, you just don't have a chance to catch your breath. I mean, you've got guys up and down the lineup that's got some serious power, and you really don't feel like you can pitch around anyone.
Base hit right field. The ACC's best player aboard to start the bottom of the inning. Going the opposite way.
Yeah, great piece of hitting right there. You got to let that ball travel deep into the strike zone. You try to go get that ball in the outside corner. You're going to roll over the top of it, ground out to shortstop. Just a nice piece of hitting by Josh McLean.
Troy, here's the best player, North Carolina State, with the best power, and that's Brett Kinnaman. Kinnerman on the season with 17 home runs, and five players have double-digit homers for this North Carolina State team. Kinnerman, by the way, homered in four consecutive games this season. The shift is on right now. Ball in the dirt, good save.
You see Kinnerman with that really open stance, and a lot of times when you see guys with an open stance, they're trying to get that back eye, or in Kinnaman's case, that left eye, to be able to turn a little bit better to see the pitch. I'll talk about it a little bit more after this pitch is over.
Kinnerman to be followed by Will Wilson and then Patrick Bailey here in the NC State first.
But a lot of times what guys do, hitters, everybody has a dominant eye. And if your dominant eye is your back eye, you've got to get your head turned toward the pitcher to get a better look at the pitch. So a lot of guys don't even know they're really doing it, but they do it so they can get that head turned. That's why they have that open stance.
Up the middle, because of the shift, a perfect double play. Well, that's why Army does what it does. And Kinnerman retired 6-4-3.
Yeah, ball any other day of the week is going to be a base hit right back through the box.
Absolutely.
The shortstop playing in the second base position. That was Martin that gobbled that ball up and created the double play.
Yeah, retired 6-3, I should say. As the second baseman, who was shaded over to the right, didn't have to do anything. Two away, nobody out for Will Wilson. On the bounce toward short, base hit center field. Second hit of the inning for the Wolfpack. Talk so much about their power, and why not Troy with 81 homers, but get on base a lot with base hits, they steal bases. I mean, they are a well-rounded machine.
Yeah, that's right. They can beat you in several different ways, and you can teach a lot of kids a lot of things, but speed is one that's a tough one. You can work on it, but guys with speed just change the game when they get on base.
Besides being second-team All-ACC, Patrick Bailey has a grand slam to his credit this year. Army trying to work out of the first inning.
Jim, we talked about how this is just it's really going to set the tone of this game and see if Army can just kind of, it's almost like going up against a heavyweight boxer. You just got to survive that first inning, and then maybe you can kind of grind through the match.
Of course, it could be argued because of the regimen that Army goes through every day that perhaps there shouldn't be any reason for jitters. They've already been through the toughest stuff. Base hits bank toward left field. Third hit of the inning. North Carolina State not being fooled by any of the pitches by Johnston. So it's first and second with two outs for Brock Detheridge.
Good job by Bailey. Just kind of goes down and gets that hanging breaking ball that just didn't have enough bite on it. Started a little too high in the strike zone. Like you said, at a third hit of this inning, and if it wasn't for that double play, the Wolfpack would be chalking up some runs on the board right about now.
Yes, think how important that shift was, in which the shortstop, Martin, was in perfect position to turn a double play. Detheridge, a career hitter at 285, homered a month ago at Florida State. Called strike.
Well, base hit to the outfield is going to score a run from second base. First of all, you've got great speed out there in Wilson, but the Army outfield is playing very deep. Kind of respecting that power.
And it's lefty here versus lefty. Detheridge, by the way, had a couple of situations this year against Virginia Tech and Clemson where he had four hits in each of those games. Two on, two outs. Opportunity for the Pack to go ahead.
Pretty good location by Giovinco, staying away from Detheridge. So you want to keep the ball away from these power hitters, but they've got the ability to go opposite field as well.
Let's see what he throws on one and two, trying to get out of the jam. Working off the stretch. Another good stop by Rozoff, who's had a perfect fielding position this year. when you look at numbers, he has not made an error in 479 chances.
Wow, that's like video game numbers right there. That's crazy.
And for your catcher spot, how huge is that?
Oh, just the ability to be able to throw that last pitch with runners on is big.
He's already blocked a couple. 2-2, two aboard, and two out. And now full count, and the advantage to North Carolina State is both runners, Wilson and Bailey, will be off on the pitch. Which means one in the gap could score two. It's a big moment right now for Giovinco.
I come back with a breaking ball right here. You do have a base open. Try to see if you can get a swing and miss in this first inning.
Got exactly that. Good call. NC State with three hits, threatens, but fails to score. 5, 6, and 7 hitters. The Cadets coming up in the second in a scoreless game. And networks bring you every game on the road to Omaha. Regional coverage on ESPN2, ESPNU, LHN, SEC Network, and ESPN3. Whip-around coverage available through ESPN3, the Bases Loaded channel, and all coverage available on the ESPN app. It's been a good day for the Southeast Conference, winning all but one. And a rough day for the Big Ten, having lost one, threatening to lose two. NC State defensively is as good as any school, I think, Troy, in the country, with Kinnaman and McLean, a combined one error on the season.
Yeah, that's just crazy. They can really cover the outfield as well out there, too. And, again, it gives the pitching staff for Wolfpack a lot of confidence to pitch to contact, not feeling like you have to strike everyone out.
This is the shortstop, Trey Martin, hitting in the 5 spot, leading off for Army in the second. Played in 45 games this year, so he's missed a dozen or so. Facing Reed Johnston, who gave up an infield hit with 2 outs in the first. And that was it. Two balls on a strike. Army with a difficult task tonight. And a victory here would really send this regional on its heels. But the support coming in for the Cadets, not only across the country, but throughout the world, the number of people serving overseas. Hit toward left field, trying to get to the outside line. It's out of play, long strike 2-2. Consider the fact that so many are serving this great country, and a lot of them have been in touch with players, coaches, and managers about making the regional.
Yeah, they're really proud of this baseball team that Army's put together. That ball's hammered down the left field line.
And foul.
Just foul. Kind of when it gets down that left field line, it goes out of our sight, so we have to kind of wait till the umpire makes his ruling if it's going to be fair or foul. You saw those arms go up and the ball that just hooked foul.
Well, imagine hearing from somebody in high command serving overseas and good luck.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Beat NC State, win the regional.
We always have respect for your opponent, but I think NC State probably has a little extra respect for their opponent in the Black Knights today.
Reed Johnston's first strikeout of the game against Trey Martin, one out.
Good pitch on by Johnson. Got that, see a little bit of run on that last pitch. Got in under the hands of Trey Martin. Again, sometimes it's not always about velocity. It's about location and movement on a pitch. Guys that throw hard but straight are going to get hit. And that's nice glove side runner, arm side runner, excuse me, for Reed Johnston.
Matt Hudgens to the plate from Las Vegas, Nevada. Count even, a ball and a strike. Giovinco, the pitcher, is also from Vegas, so both of these guys are well vested or invested in the Stanley Cup Finals, with Vegas competing for the Cup. They were disappointed, though, in the lost couple nights ago against the Capitals, but They still expect good things to happen.
And they said there's a lot of time left, a lot of games left to be played.
Absolutely. 1-2 pitch.
See that run on that fastball by Johnston. David, that's a tough pitch to take when that thing starts on the outside corner and then kind of dives down and away. You got Reed. Let's go.
Earlier today, Auburn with 17 hits beat Northeastern 13-4. Tigers are doing some scouting tonight, awaiting the winner in tomorrow night's winner's bracket, while Northeastern will play for its baseball life tomorrow afternoon against the loser of this game. Once again, the 2-2 pitch. This one over the group of fans. We're sitting up on the hill. That's a good spot over there, by the way.
I'm telling you, they're catching some rays over there still after 7 o'clock.
Absolutely. Kind of a first-come, first-serve position. That got sawed off there.
You don't see that very often. The composite bat, the BB Corps bat, broke. Just ended up splinters.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think the guy on deck appreciated that too much. Watch this. This is called sawing someone off.
Oh, yeah.
With a BB Corps aluminum bat. That ball just, that just snaps.
Look at that right there.
That's crazy.
So Hutchins has a brand new bat and still hanging in there on a 2-2 count.
You got to laugh a little bit on that.
Oh, sure. It's a rare occasion, rare occurrence. Able to stay alive. Pretty good battle going here in the top of the second. Just one major surprise today, and that was Mississippi State giving up 20 runs in the loss to Oklahoma 20-10. Count works full 3-2.
That was a football score game there. The Sooners can really swing it.
Stunning, too. Titus Drake, the seventh hitter, would be next. Good piece of hitting by Hutchins. And a good look at ball four. Army has its second base runner for Drake, who has scored 40 runs on the season. That's second best in the Army Black Knights lineup. Well, we know that Army likes to run bases, so you start running here, you think.
I don't know. Sometimes you have to pick which who you got on first base.
Fastball called, strike one.
Of all the guys that run, Matt Hutchins only has 8 attempts, and he's 5-for-8. I think they're going to probably keep him staying put over there at first base.
So not likely.
Just doesn't look like a base stealer to me. I'll put it that way.
Army starting lineup has a collective 87 steals this year. Bunting down the first baseline, fielded by Edwards. He'll apply the tag.
They're going to call a foul.
Nope, foul ball. So we'll do it again. NC State fans said, wait a minute, look fair to us. We can show you replay, but there is no replay that the umpires will use to overturn calls. So no matter how much griping goes on, play will not be reversed. What do you think, Troy?
That ball's pushed down the line. Let's see if he fields it in front of his body, foul. Yeah, he's definitely in foul ground. The glove is, when he made contact with the baseball, it was the right call.
Count moves to nothing and two.
Ken Langford, the home plate umpire. I don't think he's going to get any Christmas cards from the Wolfpack faithful here.
Again, we'll see regional, super regional action that will consist of replays, but not in the opening round.
One thing that's really made Reed Johnston the
freshman successful. 6 of 7 with first pitch strike. So, you know, that's what his coaching staff wanted him to do. Young man, just go out there and throw strikes. This is a team that's probably not going to pound the ball, baseball out of the yard. Only 8 home runs collectively for the season by the Black Knights. So, pitch to contact.
And yet to Army's advantage, they're waiting on pitches, not swinging at bad ones so far, and have worked the pitch count already to 31 here early in the second inning.
Yeah, that may be by design. They're a team that's patient at the plate. And when you don't hit a lot of home runs, you get to get guys on base, and that's one way to do it is get walks.
Strike 3 called. Second strike out of the inning by Reed Johnston. John McKenna, the first baseman, will bat next to the eighth spot and another look.
Well, just a perfect location right there. And we talked about the run on that pitch, and I think that's why he gets that call, is that ball starts off the plate and that good movement back over that outside corner, and great job by Patrick Bailey, the catcher. A lot of times good catchers that are quiet behind the plate will still use some strikes, and that was kind of on the borderline. But when you're quiet back there and receiving the baseball, that's what umpires like to see.
The batter, John McKenna, is from Parkland, Florida. You know all about the tragedy that hit that unfortunate city and school. In fact, his high school was the one that was involved. His brother and sister were in the school when the shooting took place, but escaped uninjured. And McKenna, among other things, received a cap autographed by the Hall of Famer Dwight Evans, the Boston Red Sox. Two and one.
Well, the Wolfpack are playing a little bit of a shift of their own. They've got White, the second baseman, playing almost directly behind second base. Wilson, the shortstop, deep on the grass, almost in the sixth hole.
That one toward the right field line and foul. Should also mention that David Vasquez of the North Carolina State Wolfpack is from the Parkland, Florida area. Mentioned that when McKenna found out about the tragedy and the fact that his brother and sister were in that school, he still had to play a game after that and actually performed very well under nearly impossible circumstances.
Yeah, that's just you can't even really comprehend what that young man was going through at that time.
We have 2 outs, a 2-2 count, top of the second, no score. North Carolina State threatened in its half of the first but failed to score. Base runner is Matt Hudgens, who reached on a one-out walk. Johnson a chance to strike out the side. Pretty impressive. Earlier today, Auburn with 17 hits beat Northeastern 13-4. Tigers are doing some scouting tonight, awaiting the winner in tomorrow night's winner's bracket, while Northeastern will play for its baseball life tomorrow afternoon against the loser of this game. Once again, the 2-2 pitch. This one over the group of fans. We're sitting up on the hill. That's a good spot over there, by the way.
I'm telling you, they're catching some rays over there still after 7 o'clock.
Absolutely. In a first come, first serve position. That got sawed off there.
You don't see that very often. The composite bat, the BB Corps bat, broke. Just ended up splinters.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think the guy on deck appreciated that too much. Watch this. This is called sawing someone off.
Oh, yeah.
with a BB Core aluminum bat. That ball just snaps.
Look at that right there.
That's crazy.
So Hudgens has a brand new bat and still hanging in there on a 2-2 count.
You got to laugh a little bit on that.
Oh, sure. It's a rare occasion, rare occurrence. Able to stay alive. Pretty good battle going here in the top of the second. Just one major surprise today, and that was Mississippi State giving up 20 runs in the loss to Oklahoma 20-10. Count works full, 3-2.
That was a football score game there. The Sooners can really swing it.
Stunning, too. Titus Drake, the seventh hitter, would be next. Good piece of hitting by Hudgens. And a good look at ball four. Army has its second base runner for Drake, who has scored 40 runs on the season. That's second best in the Army Black Knights lineup. Well, we know that Army likes to run bases, so you start running here, you think.
I don't know. Sometimes you have to pick who you got on first base.
Fastball called, strike one.
Of all the guys that run, Matt Hudgens only has 8 attempts and he's 5-for-8. I think they're going to probably keep him staying put over there at first base.
So not likely.
Just doesn't look like a base stealer to me. I'll put it that way.
Army starting lineup has a collective 87 steals this year. Bunting down the first baseline, fielded by Edwards. He'll apply the tag.
They're going to call it foul.
Nope, foul ball. So we'll do it again. NC State fans said, wait a minute. Look fair to us. We can show you replay, but there is no replay that the umpires will use to overturn calls. So no matter how much griping goes on, play will not be reversed. What do you think, Troy?
That ball is pushed down the line. Let's see if he fields it in front of his body foul. Yeah, he's definitely in foul ground. The glove is. When he made contact with the baseball, it was the right call.
Count moves to nothing and two.
Ken Langford, the home plate umpire. I don't think he's going to get any Christmas cards from the Wolfpack faithful here.
Again, we'll see regional, super regional action that will consist of replays, but not in the opening round.
One thing that's really made Reed Johnson, the freshman, successful, 6-of-7 with first pitch strike. So, you know, that's what his coaching staff wanted him to do. Young man, just go out there and throw strikes. This is a team that's probably not going to pound the ball, baseball out of the yard, only 8 home runs collectively for the season by the Black Knights. So, pitch to contact.
And yet, to Army's advantage, they're waiting on pitches, not swinging at bad ones so far, and have worked the pitch count already to 31 here early in the second inning.
Yeah, that may be by design. They're a team that's patient at the plate. And when you don't hit a lot of home runs, you get to get guys on base, and that's one way to do it is get walks.
Strike three called. Second strike out of the inning by Reed Johnston. John McKenna, the first baseman, will bat next to the eighth spot, and another look.
Oh, just a perfect location right there. And we talked about the run on that pitch, and I think that's why he gets that call, is that ball starts off the plate and that good movement back over that outside corner. And great job by Patrick Bailey, the catcher. A lot of times good catchers that are quiet behind the plate will still use some strikes, and that was kind of on the borderline. But when you're quiet back there and receiving the baseball, that's what umpires like to see.
The batter, John McKenna, is from Parkland, Florida. You know all about the tragedy that hit that unfortunate city and school. In fact, his high school was the one that was involved. His brother and sister were in the school when the shooting took place, but escaped uninjured. And McKenna, among other things, received a cap autographed by the Hall of Famer Dwight Evans, the Boston Red Sox. Two and one.
Well, the Wolfpack are playing a little bit of a shift of their own. They've got White, the second baseman, playing almost directly behind second base. Wilson, the shortstop, deep on the grass, almost in the six hole.
That one toward the right field line and foul. Should also mention that David Vasquez of the North Carolina State Wolfpack is from the Parkland, Florida area. Mentioned that when McKenna found out about the tragedy and the fact that his brother and sister were in that school, he still had to play a game after that and actually performed very well under nearly impossible circumstances.
Yeah, that's just you can't even really comprehend what that young man was going through at that time.
We have two outs, a 2-2 count, top of the second, no score. North Carolina State threatened in its half of the first but failed to score. Base runner is Matt Hudgens, who reached on a one-out walk. Johnson a chance to strike out the side. Pretty impressive second inning. Hitter 6, 7, and 8 due up for NC State in the second. We take a look at the Army defense. Couple of players worth noting. Anthony Crompton in left field, just two errors. And again, John Rosoff behind the plate, 479 opportunities for an error. He has made none.
That's just crazy. It's crazy at any position, but at the catcher position as well, you think about how many times you're thrown behind runners, trying to pick a guy off, or all the opportunities you have.
Evan Edwards leading off the bottom of the second. You were nice enough to share off mic that as a fielder in the College World Series, you had a tough chance on a play, and it was so noted the opposite way by then-commentator Joe Morgan. Huh?
Yeah, so I get a Hall of Famer sitting there going, just Eklund got eat up by that ball. I was trying to play first base, and it wasn't a pretty attempt. And he let all the fans know about it that were watching on TV. It was quite comical.
Well, you're famous or infamous. Bounce toward first base. And I believe it was rule foul, or was it? Evan Edwards is not sure.
Ken Langford, the home plate umpire, said, no, that hit in front of home plate.
Yeah, he didn't call anything, that's for sure.
Hey, let Avant's going to come out and get an explanation of what happened here. He's going to ask his player. He said, did I hit you in the foot? So he hit me in the toe.
That's what he's saying.
Now, what they can do is maybe have a conference between the umpires and see if anybody else may have seen that the ball hit the batter's foot, but they definitely are not replaying it.
Well, the reason that Edwards didn't run is he thought he had hit the foot, and it almost looks like he got the right foot there.
Man, it sure looks like it hit the foot.
In fact,
even kind of shaking it out right there.
So, again, without the availability of TV replay and overturn, it'll go as a recorded out, unassisted by the first baseman. Jack Conley to the plate, career hitter 321 in limited amount of bats. 27 hits, 84 opportunities. Towards third on one hop. No problem for Jakeen, two outs.
Just a little bit surprised that the umpires at least didn't have an umpire conference just to see if anybody else saw the ball hit the batter's foot.
I would think that Morris Hodges, the first base umpire, would be the one that might be in the best position for an overturn on that. But he wasn't approached, so there are two outs, nobody on for Stephen Patera, the third baseman, making his 117th career start. you know, compared to the first game and how that began with all the hits and the walks. It's a well-played game, at least to start. JT Jarrett, the second baseman, who hits in the ninth spot, would bat next. Sun has gone away for a moment. It's about one of the few times that's happened today. Count now 1-2.
Giovinco is really working both sides of the play. Kind of that first strike was on the outside corner, kind of went back in right there. He's a guy that's not going to blow you away with that fastball, so he definitely has to hit his spots. Tried to overthrow that breaking ball and spiked it about 58 feet.
I would assume umpires like that type of control, and it leads to a speedier game potentially. 2-2, two outs. Toward right field, going to be caught. Good play by Titus Drake, inning over. After two, underdog Army and NC State, nothing. Jim Foster, the head coach of Army, and that's his son to his left. Foster's second season as a head coach at a record of 61-53. It was the boss of Rhode Island from 06 to 14. His son with those cool sunglasses on, yeah. By the way, asked a question during the press conference yesterday of some of his
Bros off the catcher.
Army players, yeah.
He said, what's it like to be the catcher, kind of be the captain on the field? And he said, it's good. It's good to be involved in almost every play.
It's a good question.
Naturally, he's a catcher too, so he was kind of giving himself a pat on the back about his position. You got to love that.
Left fielder Anthony Crompton in the ninth spot for Army leads off. Then it's back to the top of the order. And Jacob Hurtubise. Reed Johnston struck out the side for NC State in the second. Good game to this point. Nothing in the third. And now a stoppage in play. We'll have a change of baseballs. In this game right now in the shade.
If he did something to the baseball, then why did he put the baseball back in his pouch? I'm trying to figure out why he went out there to change baseballs and keep that baseball. Not really sure what that was.
41st pitch from Reed Johnston. NC State, by virtue of the fact, one seed here, 16 overall, is the favorite to win this regional. But really struggled down the stretch of the ACC regular season, the tournament, losing five straight.
Good job by Crompton just to spoil that pitch. Good location by Johnson on the outside half.
Crompton from Moline, Illinois. Fourth strikeout by Johnston. Anthony thought he had ball four. And so that's four straight by Reed Johnston.
That pitch is right down Broadway. I'm not really sure where he thought that was. Maybe he thought it was a little bit in. Got to remember about the run that Johnston has. It's where it crosses home plate, not where the catcher catches the baseball. Still thought it caught the plate.
Hurtubise, base hit right field. And now the nation's best base stealer is aboard with one out. And this ought to be a fun duel because behind home plate is Patrick Bailey, who's very good at throwing people out.
That ball is torched right past Jarrett, the second baseman. Made a great attempt, but just couldn't get it. Ball's hit too hard.
Well, you got to expect Hurtubise in what could be a tightly contested game to challenge right now is North Carolina State defense. He'll take a nice lead at first.
It doesn't take long for him to get a pickoff play over there, so his speed just changes everything. I'm telling you, it's in Reed Johnson's head. He knows he's got the nation's leading base stealer on first base. He's going to probably call a lot more fastballs. Also makes the pitcher try to deliver to home plate a little quicker.
NC State so good defensively, facing its first challenge of this game with Herdebees, who is 40 of 46 in stolen bases. Solid lead at first base, and now diving back into first.
Let's see if Johnson continues to throw fastballs in this situation. Trying to give his catcher a little extra time. Try to catch a potential base stealer.
It's a pretty good battle up here.
You got to think, you got a freshman on the mound. You don't want too much of that attention to be over at first base. Got to concentrate on the hitter.
Herdebees going. Throw down to second. In there, another stolen base, is 41st of the season at 47 attempts.
Man, he can really scoot. Not a bad throw right there by Bailey. Some guys slow down when they start their slide. I think Herdebees speeds up. He just exploded into second base. Kind of a very late slide. You can see him almost slide past with all that momentum, slide past first, second base. He had to kind of stick that toe out there to kind of hang on.
Big opportunity, scoring opportunity for John Rozoff, a 351 hitter. Base hit. Likely will put Army ahead. Now, if you're Herdebees, do you think about trying to swipe third?
You know, there's one out. I stay put. You know, could he possibly steal third base? Yes, but he's going to score on a base hit. The only thing that does is that a sac fly is going to score a run. I just don't think you take that chance. He's got a huge lead out there at second base. Nobody's keeping him close.
And Rozoff has now worked the count to 3-1. Johnston very careful with Army's best hitter. Josh White, who reached on an infield single, would bat next for the Black Knights in a scoreless game in the top of the third.
Yeah, if I'm Reed Johnson, I am very careful to Rozoff right here. You've got first base open. You set up the double play. And went up and in. That's a tough ball to handle right there by Rozoff. But the Army lineup is not the same as the Wolfpack lineup. They're not near as deep from 1 through 9. So this is the guy that NC State cannot let beat them is Rozoff.
The only 300 hitter or better in this Army attack. 3-2 pitch, runner going toward first base. Throw to the pitcher. Here comes a runner home. Safe! Well, because Herdebees was on the move on the slap toward first base, he didn't stop running. And Army takes a 1-0 lead.
Well, that's what speed does for you. It creates opportunities. Good job by John Rozoff just to put the ball in play. See the pitcher covering. A little bit of a hesitation as he hit the bag before he spun and went home. Herdebees, a slight hesitation around third base, just enough. I think the first baseman, Edwards, fields the ball and he looks up and he sees Herdebees rounding second, rounding third, and kind of stop or pause. So that's when he goes ahead and flips to the pitcher. Herdebees sees it, and I like the play by Army. They're not going to have a lot of scoring opportunities. They've got to take advantage when they have the opportunity.
Army small ball. Base hit, stolen base, score all the way from second on a ground out. Picture perfect. 1-1 to Josh White toward right field. Should end the inning. And on the play of Jacob Huddeby's running the bases, the Black Knights lead NC State 1-0 as we head to the bottom of the third. Our statistician, John Madry, informs us that is an RBI situation for John Rozoff. Gets credit for one in which Jacob Huddeby scored all the way from second on a ground out.
To first base, no less.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty amazing.
JT Jarrett leading off the NC State third. Count even, a ball and a strike. Tyler Gianvico, the starting pitcher tonight for Army of West Point. After Jarrett, back to the top of the order for the Wolfpack. Toward center field. Jacob Herdebees, one out. For more coverage of the Division I Baseball Regionals and interactive brackets, go to NCAA.com. Troy Eklund, Jim Barber. Bottom of the third inning in a rapidly moving game led by Army 1-0. The winner gets Auburn tomorrow night. The loser will try to stay alive in an elimination game against Northeastern tomorrow afternoon. Towards short. Army getting a lot of good bounces so far in this game. Two outs. And a throw by Trey Martin, who already has a couple of assists in this game.
Good hustle by Josh McClain down the line, but nice play by Martin. He knows who's running. He's got to release that ball in a hurry. Army playing the shift right here.
Worked nicely in the first inning, didn't it?
It really did. You've got White going to play in shallow right field. The shortstop behind second base. Look how deep McKenna, the first baseman's playing.
Almost looks like the defense for Kyle Schwarber of the Cubs.
I saw a highlight that Robinson Cano came up like this, bunted a ball hard down the third baseline for a double on the shift. That's how you beat it.
Well, you know what? It's going to bring back fundamental baseball and bunting to some hitters who have long distance themselves from it. Kinnaman grounded into that shifty 6-3 double play the last time up, and the count now 1-2. Giovinco winds down the first baseline, fair into the right field corner. Good care of Kinnerman, and he's going to have to hold up. As because the bounce came out into fair territory, much to the disappointment of the fans, Kinnerman decided the better of it and to hold up.
That ball scorched right down the first base line. You see Morris Hodges, the first base umpire, all over that. Kinnerman holds up, but you know what makes that play? Keeps Kinnerman at first base is White, the second baseman, is playing shallow right field. He's the one who goes out there and fields that baseball. He's probably 30, 40 feet deep into right field.
That's a good point.
That's why he's out there. The right fielder has to come in and get that baseball. The runner's at second base.
If it went deep in the corner, he could have served as the cutoff man, but you're right. He was like another outfielder.
Yeah.
Here's Will Wilson, who had a hit in the first. NC State with a 4-2 hit advantage, but trailing 1-0. Things cooling down just a bit here in Raleigh. Wilson, by the way, is from Kings Mountain, North Carolina, who in a couple of seasons reached base in 39 consecutive games. Started 61 games as a freshman. And Kings Mountain, North Carolina is near the bigger city of Charlotte.
Giovinco is paying a lot of attention to Kinnaman at first base. He is 9 of 12 in stolen bases. Now Will Wilson, the home batter at the plate, calls timeout.
Giovinco must suspect something here. And finally on his first pitch to Will Wilson, delivers a strike.
We talked about Army speed and how they're a threat to run. This Wolfpack team can run too.
Count even, a ball and a strike. Patrick Bailey hitting in the fourth spot would be next. Nationally 16th seeded NC State at the plate. Toward third base. Inning over. Two out single by Kinnaman wasted. And after three, bit of a surprise. Army 1, NC State nothing. Black Knights had a number of selections in the All-Patriot League, starting with John Rozoff, Anthony Jakeen, and Jacob Hurtubise, all first-teamers, and then Burgraff, Giovinco, Op White, and Titus, second-teamers. As we start the top of the fourth with Jakeen, Army's typical day in New York is atypical for most college students. Begins with a wake-up at 6:30 or 06:30. Then a morning formation at 06:55, then breakfast at 07:00, followed by classes of almost 4.5 hours, a lunch formation, and then lunch, then labs, lectures, honor and ethics discussions for another hour, then class, practice, namely, in this case, baseball, dinner, homework, and to sleep by 00:30.
Oh, it sounds like a walk in the park.
Oh, yeah.
Good night. That's what we talked about these Army guys. When they get on the road, they love it because they don't have to wake up at the crack of dawn, literally at the crack of dawn, for formation. And they don't have to stand in formation before they get to eat breakfast.
Yes.
Or lunch. It's a big deal.
Jakeen takes ball four. Good start for Army of West Point to start the fourth inning. And by the way, the first time that the Cadets have the leadoff hitter aboard.
The shortstop, number 6, Trey Martin.
So Anthony Jakeen, 5 for 5 in stolen bases, so not a giant threat. Army's got three guys in the starting lineup in double-digit attempts.
But you know, why not force the issue?
You got no outs. I don't think you do it yet.
Showing bunt, throw into right field. Cross up there. Jakeen around second base. Heading into third, an Army with another threat to start the fourth.
Some miscommunication by Bailey, the catcher, and Edwards, the first baseman. Edwards is starting to crash because he thinks that's where the ball is going to be bunted, which he's right. That's more of a mental error on the catcher than it is Edwards at first base. He's charging to get ready to field the bunt.
Bailey's seventh error of the year, and now runner at third, nobody out. You wonder how NC State is going to play this. Both short and second were coming in, but now they have backed up to a normal spot. This one, spanked toward left field, caught. Runner going to try to score. Throw to home plate, off mark, 2-0 Army.
Like the old saying goes, walks come back to haunt you. That was a base on balls by Reed Johnston that started everything. And then the throwing error, two base throwing error by Bailey, the catcher.
Well, think about it, Troy. In this game, Jacob Hurtubise took two bases to score a run in the Army third. And then Jakeen went from first to third on a throwing error and eventually scored like Hurtubise. High fly ball hit to right center field. It's going to be in play, though.
McLean is as good as it gets out there in center field. He can really go get a ball. You've got to love it if you're a pitcher. When you see one hit to center field, and you just kind of exhale because you know he's going to run one down.
Two outs now, top of the fourth. Titus Drake coming to the plate, a strikeout victim in the second. has a home run, 29, batted in. So the small ball of Army so far has been dominant in this game. Goes as an unearned run. But a big run for Army of West Point. Think about it, Troy, the longer this game goes and the longer Army leads, the feeling in the North Carolina State dugout is going to be one of concern.
Well, it starts putting a little bit of pressure on the team that is expected to win, which in this case is the Wolfpack. They're the number one seed.
For the shortstop, Will Wilson. In the inning, a walk, a throwing error, and a sack fly. Army 2, NC State nothing, 4, 5, and 6 coming up for the Wolfpack in the bottom of the inning. Play regional, Patrick Bailey, Brock Detheridge, and Evan Edwards up for NC State. In the pack, half of the fourth, now trailing 2 to nothing. Got to show you an interesting graphic here in a moment. We told you that the Army is in single digits in total home runs. For the record, 9 of them, and we'll show you what the numbers are for NC State, not as a team, but individually. It's really kind of stunning. They have 5 in double figures with home runs. Army as a team is not even into double figures with 9.
You got several guys battling with two home runs. You're tied for the team lead with 2. Tell you what, baseball can be won in several different ways.
Oh, yes. 2-1 pitch. Toward center field. Well in the play, no problem. Hurtubise, one out. One of the things that impresses you about Army, at least to this point, through 3 1/3, is how defensively sound the Black Knights are.
They really have been. They fielding the ball very well. They feel like they belong in this ballgame. They belong in this regional and really kind of taking it to heart. I think if you're an NC State fan, you got to think your hitters have got to start taking the ball up the middle of the other way. That ball's juiced right there, but right at Hurtubise, the center fielder. Can't hit it much harder than that if you're Brock Detheridge. But again, with the guy, a soft throwing lefty, you know he's not going to blow the ball by you. Mentally, your approach needs to be up the middle the other way. So if you see guys pulling balls, things like that, you're well out in front. Got to stay back in the baseball. Don't be afraid to let that ball travel a little bit.
Back-to-back catches now by center fielder Jacob Hurtubise, who has 3 putouts for the game. Evan Edwards now to the plate, and grounded out unassisted, first base. Wolfpack had a good scoring opportunity in the first with 2 aboard and 2 outs, failed to score. Since then, just a single base runner. 1-1. Would you say that Army has the potential to be a major Cinderella story?
Oh, it'd be huge for Army to pick off NC State right here. A lot of baseball still left to play.
Giovinco, 2-1.
And good location right underneath the hands of Edwards.
Start to hear this crowd, though, mumbling a little bit.
A little murmuring out
there. Yeah, like, this isn't supposed to be happening. 2-2 pitch, base hit right field. Tell you what, they're not getting cheated at the plate. You're right, they're getting some pretty good licks in there. And that is hit number 5 for the Pack.
Well, you know the Pack can swing the bat. Edwards does a good job right there. Gets that ball up in the zone. You saw him make contact right about belt high. That's where, you know, Giovinco, he can't live there. He's not a guy that's going to be throwing 95 that can blow that ball by you belt high. He's got to get work down in the zone and on the corners. See in the top right, you see the Arkansas Oral Roberts score 10-2. Arkansas wins that and moves on to the next round in the Fayetteville Regional.
LSU a winner earlier today, 6-4 over San Diego State. Jack Conley from Raleigh, North Carolina, the hometown kid.
I think that kind of changes the game up a little bit. If you're the Wolfpack, you might be aggressive. You can't do it right here.
Third to first, inning over. NC State shut out through four. Army 2, Pack nothing. Bottom of the Army order in the top of the fifth. Special hello to all those serving in the United States Army across this great country and across the world. Checking in on Army's performance, which to this point has been quite good. And John McKenna, hit by a pitch, will start the Black Knights fifth with the team already ahead, 2-0.
Let me ask you this, Jim. If I was about to say that Reed Johnson was 12 of 16 in first pitch strikes, but I didn't say it, but I'm holding the card.
Glad you held off.
Is that still jinxing him?
Probably. So don't do that again.
Oh, my goodness. I just got the note.
Crompton in a sacrifice situation for the Black Knights. Showing bunt, taking it back. Here's the small ball that Army displays, and to this point has been a real problem for NC State.
And if I'm Army, why not take a chance right here? Why not square and pull the bat back and let the guy take a swing? You know, you get different terminology. We used to call it a slug bunt. I've heard it called a slash bunt or butcher boy or something, all kinds of different terminology. But square, get infielders moving around, everybody shuffling around, and you got to hit that ball on the ground if you take a swing.
There's activity in the Wolfpack bullpen as Reed Johnston is about to reach 70 pitches. But in fairness, this hasn't been his fault. Great base running by Jacob Hurtubise to take two on an infield ground out, scoring Army's first run, and then a throwing error and a cross-up between catcher and first baseman has led to the Black Knights' second run.
Connor Santella warming up in the bullpen, and left-hander because you've got a right-hander at the plate right now, but then the lefty John McKenna is on deck. So if they bunt, they're thinking they're probably going to get to a left-hander hitter, try to go the lefty-lefty matchup. But I'm telling you, if I'm Army, I'm pulling out all the stops. I'm not doing a sacrifice bunt. The Wolfpack are crashing in. The third baseman, Patera, is playing on the grass. He is playing down the throat of the batter.
Crompton is their best bunter. He has 10 sacrifice bunts this year.
I'm telling you, I show, pull that bat back, take a hack, try to hit something on the ground.
Back to the top of the order in the Army fifth in a moment. There's the bunt. Count even, a ball and a strike. What a contrast. We're just showing in the upper right-hand corner the 20-10 score. And in the bottom, it's 2-0. And Army small ball has been the difference.
Strikes is key right here by Reed Johnston.
Crompton to first base. Tagged out. Good sacrifice. His 11th of the season. And Hurtubise now into scoring position. Another scoring opportunity for Army, though. And Jacob Hurtubise grounded out first to second in the first inning, then singled, stole a base, and scored on an infield grounder by John Rozoff. He is coming to the plate. And that likely is going to be it for Reed Johnston. He went 4 1/3 and allowed just 2 hits and 1 earned run. So pitching change for NC State. Trying to keep this game at 2-0 here in the fifth inning. J. Should get a solid round of applause. He's pitched well. But trails 2-0. We'll be back. Watching the NCAA Baseball Regionals presented by Capital One here at Doak Field on the campus of NC State. In the Raleigh Regional, 2-0 Army, and pitching change, Connor Centella, the left-hander from Tampa, Florida, is on. Strong ERA of 1.86 in 9.2 innings of work, and he has thrown 5 shutout innings recently.
Yeah, sometimes you see hitters get hot. Same thing can happen to a pitcher. They get hot. So definitely going with the percentages here. If you're Elliott Avant, with the lefty-lefty matchup against Army's best hitter in Jacob Hurtubise, I'm still really careful with him. I don't want to make a mistake to this guy.
John Rozoff, who is a tad now under 350 as a hitter, would bat next. Man at second, one out, top of the fifth. Think about how important a run for Army would be here, because now you're starting to think that that long ball, which has been dormant for NC State in 4 innings, is going to have to take over with men on base maybe to have a chance. Strike called.
Really good pitch and location. Another perfect spot by Centella. Outside corner. Now you need a big strikeout.
No balls, 2 strikes. Man at second, 1 out here in the fifth. Centella from the stretch, and a look back to second. And he throws one out of the zone as a waste pitch, 1-2. Army during the regular season played consecutive doubleheaders on weekend dates as part of the Patriot League schedule.
They do a lot of things different in the Patriot League, I'm telling you.
That one gets away. McKenna on the third base. Now through the Wolfpack, you got to think about pulling your infield in. You no longer worry about the big inning. You worry about any run in any inning. And they're going to do exactly that.
Well, here's something that Army does a lot is safety squeeze. You've got a guy that can really handle the bat and he can really run and hurt a bees. If it's a safety squeeze, his job has got to get the ball down. Don't worry about getting a hit.
Centella, though, gets a huge strikeout. So now 2 outs in the inning. The infield can go back to normal depth.
I know there was 2 strikes, but.
You would have squeezed?
Sometimes you got to give it a try. Very defensive swing right there by Hurtubise.
So Rozoff is 0 for 2, both infield grounders, but still Army's best hitter. Dropped 3 points to 348.
I pitch around Rozoff right here.
Yeah, I think I would
too. I
throw
everything outside off the plate, and if he swings, great. If he doesn't, no harm, no foul.
Got to make sure if you throw it off the plate, you don't throw it away. Wild pitch moments ago as a runner at third. Good pitch there, strike one. Well, if Centella can get to a second strike, I think these fans who are getting a bit nervous will rise. Try to get the punch out to end the inning.
Yeah, it'll be a big momentum shift for the Wolfpack if they can get out of this without allowing a run.
And you're right, staying away from him on this pitch, 1-1.
Here's something else to think about. Patera, the third baseman, is taking away the bunt. He is even with the bag at third, so anything hit to his left or right, he's not going to have any time at all to react. He can make the play at him, but having to take away that bunt Makes it really tough to kind of knock something down.
Now the count 1-2, and let's see what these fans here do.
And the way they're pitching Rosoff, now he can back up. That was a big pitch right there to get that second strike, because now Patera can back up to his normal depth.
We'll let you at home and watching abroad enjoy the moment. Popped up, headed toward left field. Inning over. Good job by Centella in relief. Halfway through, it remains Army 2, NC State nothing. Watching ESPN today that the Big 12 was at a big day. 3-0, Pac-12 is 2-0, ACC 1-0, and the SEC 6-1. Big 10's about to be 0-2 as Indiana, after Ohio State was defeated by South Carolina, is trailing big against Texas A&M. Stephen Patera takes a strike, 1-1. The winner gets Auburn tomorrow night, 7 o'clock Eastern. The loser will take on Northeastern at 2 o'clock tomorrow. So how big of an inning was that for NC State to escape without giving up a run?
I think it's huge. I think that is, it's going to allow them not to play as tight. I still think they're playing a little tight.
Sky toward right field, Titus Drake. So far for Army, errorless baseball.
I tell you right now, this is the time of night that the sky's not black. When the ball gets above the lights, like that last towering fly ball out, if you're a hitter, you run everything out, because that ball just kind of disappears when it goes above the lights.
Sure.
Now, when it's pitch black and the sky's dark, it's easy to see that baseball. You see a little white dot up there. But this time it gets up there and it just kind of turns to gray. As an outfielder, you really have to concentrate.
JT Jarrett hitting in the ninth spot at the plate, flied out to center field. So far, with Tyler Giovinco pushing a shutout game, he has received 5 putouts from his outfield.
Got a lot of fly ball outs by Giovinco.
Good breaking ball, 1-2.
He's just kind of getting in a groove out there on the mound. Sometimes you see pitchers that maybe labor a little bit. He is just kind of on cruise control right now.
Right back to him. He'll underhand it to first base, 2 outs. NC State has had a man aboard in every inning, but the second, and of course, this inning as well. And really, its only major threat came in the first after a double play created by an Army shift. Wiped out Kinnerman and McLean. Wilson and Bailey got hits, and they were stranded by Deatherage striking out.
Yeah, that was a huge play. You nailed it right there with the shift. And that double play, you felt like State was going to just kind of explode early on this ball game, and that just kind of took the wind out of their sails.
Josh McLean is 1-for-2. Hit it hard towards center field, but right on a dime to Hurtubise. 6 put out for the outfield. After 5, Cinderella leading 2-0. Here are some of the classes offered at the Academy. Advanced Multivariable Calculus, Electrical Power Systems, International Relations, Cybersecurity Engineering, Boxing, Combat Applications, Computer Architecture, Leadership Psychology, Survival Swimming, Disruptive Innovations, Thermal Fluid Systems, Foreign Language, Military Science, Integrative System Design, and History of the Military Art. So besides all the regimen they have, the academics, no walk in the park.
No, not at all. But what is survival swimming? I mean, do they have like 6 guys hanging on you while you try to just stay afloat? I'm just not sure what that is.
Whatever it is, I'll bet it's not easy. Trying to go the opposite way is Josh White, who's 1-for-2 as we start the 6th inning. The winner gets Auburn tomorrow night.
and probably Casey Mize.
Yeah.
That's what's really scary.
And you wonder if, as Auburn watches this game, and a lot of people anticipate it would be Auburn and NC State, if Army upsets the Wolfpack tonight, does that change the Tigers' way of thinking?
Well, Butch Thompson said that he goes, he didn't know if he's going to throw Mize in game two or game three, so he was already kind of thinking ahead to potentially save Mize. And if you, like you said, if Army upsets NC State, you kind of might play a little with a little house money and save Mize for the Sunday start.
Casey Mize projected to be the number one pick in the Major League Baseball draft Monday night, which means the Detroit Tigers would select him. And from all indications, that is expected to happen.
Well, the Tigers got Alex Faedo out of Florida last year. Come back, and the crazy thing is they had the same record, but they had a worse record the year before. It allows them to get the first pick, and I think you have to take Casey Mize. If you've had the pleasure to watch him pitch, you know, he passes the eye test. He's a guy, he's 6'3", goes about 225, big, strong kid. He's one of those guys that could easily go to the big leagues in September without a blinking an eye.
Good point. White's second hit of the game. Starts the Army sixth, and now Army has had the leadoff hitter on in each of the last three innings. Missed a scoring opportunity in the fifth. Let's see if they try to move people around with a sacrifice again here in the sixth.
Now, White has attempted 17 stolen bases, but he's only been successful six times. Again, hard to read a lefty.
Connor Centella in relief. This is right back to the pitcher, but a little too hard. And so they get the lead runner. And Jakeen now will be the base runner at first base with a man out. Goes as a fielder's choice and an unsuccessful sacrifice.
Army's going to stick with what they do best in the small ball. The left-handed batter right there, I almost like to let him swing. There's a huge hole at the first baseman covering, holding the runner on at first, and the middle infield second baseman having to kind of squeeze. There's just that giant hole over there, and with the left-handed batter, you think he can just roll something weakly. It just might find a hole. I hate giving up an out in that situation.
Base hit left field.
Wow, look how big the lack of execution of the bunt. That base hit scores a run right there, probably. It's hit pretty sharply. Might be a play at the plate, but that was a scoring opportunity the Army just missed.
So let's see if they can rebound from that with Matt Hudgens to the plate, officially 0-for-1. As Jakeen now is the lead runner at second, Trey Martin at first. Army with two hits in the inning now, four for the game.
That's probably the only miscue or lack of execution that Black Knights have had in this ball game. Everything else has been just spot on.
Saw Jim Foster moments ago. Matt Hudgens was the scheduled hitter, but Army's going to make a change here. And that'll be Rob Regine.
Number 15, Rob Regine.
So Regine gets a big opportunity here.
NC State does have a right-hander in the bullpen. Scott Foxhall out on the mound talking to his left-hander.
He's the pitching coach. Nolan Clenny, 39, has been warming for the Pack. Right now, NC State in quite a battle tonight and recognizing that, playing percentages on a number of occasions. Let's see if there'll be a pitching change or not. Foxhall's taking his time last couple years. Facing Navy, also at Camden Yards in Baltimore. It was the experience because of a Friday night scheduled game at Fenway that brought out a huge crowd and also allowed a lot of the Army cadets to walk around historic Fenway, take a lot of pictures, and pat the green monster.
Yeah, it's probably got to be a cool experience to play in Fenway. The Wolfpack bring on Nolan Clenny, the right-hander with a 3.70 ERA. He has pitched in 41 in the third innings. Opponents only hitting 208 off the right-hander. 53 strikeouts in those 41 in the third inning. So a guy that's a swing and miss guy. Also only 24 walks in those 41 innings.
NC State trying to stop a five-game losing streak. A loss tonight, while not devastating, would be huge, especially in its chances to win the regional. Casey Mize has yet to pitch for Auburn, and an Army victory means Army is a very legitimate contender for the regional title, which, by the way, they have never accomplished.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Now pitching for the Wolfpack, number 39, Nolan Clenny.
So Nolan Clenny, the right-hander, will face the right-hander Rob Regine, with Anthony Jakin, the runner at second, Trey Martin at first, the 2-0 game with a man out in the sixth.
Regine hitting 200 on the season. He does only has 25 plate appearances, but sometimes coaches just get a feel for a guy.
Army scored a run in the third on a ground out that resulted in Jacob Hurtubise taking not one but two bases from second to third to home. Then on a throwing error, followed by a sacrifice fly, added a run in the fourth. That's the only scoring in this game. Down to third baseline at fair. That's going to score another run. Here's a man around third. He's going to be held up on an RBI double by Regina. What did you say about the coach having a feeling?
You know, sometimes you watch a guy take batting practice, and you just have a feel for a player that seems like that they're just on. They're just kind of dialed in. Only 25 at-bats by Regine, but just hooks that one right inside the bag with that funky carom off the wall, bounces into left field. Good job by Kinnaman to get that ball in a hurry.
Mr. Regine hitting only 200, and now the infield must come back in again. The Wolfpack in a 3-0 hole, runners at second and third.
Now you wonder if they're going to safety squeeze right here.
Now they're playing with house money at this point. They can do whatever they want. Titus Drake takes a ball. You know, they're a base hit away from breaking this game open, potentially.
They really are.
Now, who would have thought that was going to happen tonight? By the way, Troy and Duke finally going to get underway again in Athens at 9:15 tonight after a very lengthy rain delay. That's just the first game. 1-1.
A really good slider right there by Clenny.
Well, Anthony Jakin's got to feel better. He was unable to sacrifice the runner from first to second, but eventually was able to score the third run. Infield in at every spot. Now the 1-1 pitch with a man out. Towards center field. He's going to score the fourth run potentially. Runner coming home, and the Army adds another. It's 4-0 Black Knights.
That's a little bit different than safety squeezing right there. Just balls hammered out to center field, deep enough. No play for McLean to try to come to the plate. He's wisely throws that ball to third base and keeps the runner. Regine at second base.
Now John McKenna hitting the eighth spot, struck out in the second. Was hit by a pitch in the fifth and then stranded to third base. Here in the sixth, however, the Black Knights have capitalized and really have NC State on its heels now.
NC State playing the shift. The second baseman, White, playing right back behind second base. Gigantic hole between first and second. I don't mind the shift. But you have to pitch into the shift. Like, that was a breaking ball down and away. You're setting yourself up for danger when you're throwing on the outside corner and you've got this big hole over on the right-hand side.
The ball and two strikes. Looking ahead to the NC State sixth. Power part of the lineup coming up in Kinnerman, Wilson, and Bailey. And they're going to need a few more to try to work their way back into the game. And hit by a pitch on a 1-2 pitch. McKenna's hit for the second time tonight. And it's going to allow Army to turn this lineup over again, either in this inning or in the top of the seventh, as the ninth hitter is coming to the plate in Crompton.
The left fielder, number 13, Anthony Crompton.
You think about it, Troy, I mean, the better played game tonight belongs to Army.
Yeah, they've been very solid. Again, the only thing that, the only miscue they had was the bunt attempt back to the pitcher. Other than that, they've played flawless baseball.
No mental errors and no physical errors on the scoreboard either. Crompton is 0 for 1, a strikeout and a sacrifice bunt, his 11th of the year.
You can almost hear a pin drop in this stadium right now.
These people are shocked.
Well, a team that can hit has hit 81 home runs on the season. That's something to think about. When you've got that home run potential, you're really never out of a game.
If Army wins this game, people ought to start thinking about scheduling them in the future.
Might help their RPI.
Yeah, get used to this very strong, fundamental, small ball style of baseball. Ball two strikes, two on, two outs. Army ahead 4-0. Crompton awaits the pitch. And I think some of the solid two-strike hitting, a lot of the fouled-off pitches, have driven up the pitch count a bit. Army seems very relaxed at the plate, even when their batters are defending on two strikes.
Yeah, if I'm Clinty right here, you got to go that breaking ball down off the plate. Try to expand that strike zone. I think Crompton's going to swing at anything. You throw that slider down and away, I think he's going to get a strikeout.
Said he goes up high and out of the zone, 2-2.
I still come back for that breaking ball down and away.
Toward left field and deep, but caught by the center fielder, Josh McClain, hustling over at the last minute. Yet Rob Regine off the bench delivers a huge RBI double. Army sends seven to the plate and now leads by four.
Well,
Rob Regine and Drake Titus with RBIs in the sixth inning have allowed Army to expand its lead to 4-0. Work to be done right now for NC State in a 4-0 hole.
Well, I think this first batter is key for NC State. They've got one of their best hitters at the plate, all ACC first team in Brett Kinnaman. He's down in the count 0-2, but a very good two-strike hitter. You need him on base. Again, Army playing the huge shift with Jarrett out in shallow right field, the second baseman. I think if Rosoff doesn't move so far off the plate, that's a strike. He was about a foot off the plate, and that ball might have caught the corner.
That pitch barely misses, 2-2. Right now, even with all the power the NC State possesses, they've got to think in terms of base runners. Got to get people aboard. Only had one inning. That was the first when they got more than one on. Last four hitters have been retired. Outfield of Anthony Crompton, Jacob Hurtubise, Drake Titus. Infield, Anthony Jakeen, Trey Martin, Josh White, Josh McKenna, or John McKenna, and then Tyler Gianvico and John Rosoff. Right now responsible for a shutout. Good stop by first baseman. Pitcher trying to cover in time. Well played by McKenna. Giovinco got over in time, one out.
Yeah, that ball is torched off the bat of Kinnaman. Can't hit it any harder on the ground. And great play by McKenna over there at first base. Giovinco covering.
Brings up Will Wilson, 1-for-2 in the game. To be followed by Patrick Bailey. Now 70 pitches for Tyler Giovinco, who came in with a career ERA of 4.49. And to this point, only one runner for NC State has been in scoring position. And you have to go back to the first inning when that happened. Off speed, 1-1.
You know, now you start talking about Giovinco's pitch count. And there's stress pitches and non-stress pitches. He has not made very many stressful pitches in this ball game.
That's a good point. Up the middle, base hit. Second of the game for Will Wilson. Pack trying to get a rally going in the sixth.
Boy, this crowd just waiting for something to cheer for.
Yeah, you know, and it's interesting. There hasn't been much. Good swing here on this 1-1 pitch.
Good job by Wilson. I don't know if you noticed, but he was well up in the batter's box, really trying to take away the break of that breaking ball. I mean, his foot, he was almost out of the box in front of home plate.
I think that's a change for some of these batters, potentially. And a guy that doesn't throw that fast.
Yeah, I would. I'd get up in the box.
Here's Patrick Bailey. A number of putouts recorded by the Army defense. Drake Titus in right field has three putouts. The center fielder, Jacob Hurtubise, has three. This crowd still unusually silent.
You could almost hear the groan of the crowd right there when that ball was hit foul. There's like, oh, it was foul. Just want something fair to get dropped down the line. Just create some life in this offense.
And to Tyler Giovinco's credit, he hasn't walked anybody. Ahead again on an NC State batter. And Bailey just reaching out and trying to stay alive.
Yeah, very defensive swings on a good location on those pitches.
Army has won before in a regional, but hasn't won often. And considering that the Black Knights are the fourth seed here, this would be a huge upset. Still a lot of baseball to be played, however. Towards second base. Out for one, throw over, double play. This sound, Army defense comes to the defense of its starting pitcher, Tyler Giovinco. After six, Underdog Army 4, NC State nothing. Back in the state capital of North Carolina, you're watching the NCAA Baseball Regionals presented by Capital One. Troy Eklund, Jim Barber. Lights are on downtown right now as David Harrison becomes the fourth pitcher for NC State. He will face Army's top of the order in Hurtubise. Rosoff and White. So Army is 9 outs away from recording one of its biggest victories ever. Jacob Herterbees had probably the biggest play of this game early when he got a single. As you look at Harrison's numbers, ERA of 5.4 with 19 walks, 38 hits allowed. Herterbees had a base hit with one out and a third in a scoreless game, stole second, and then had a ground ball by Rosoff to first base, in which the pitcher had to cover. Herterbees never stopped running from second all the way to home to plate the first run, and right now that's big difference in this game.
Yeah, it really is, and that speed by Army has put some pressure on that Wolfpack defense. If I'm Herterbees right here, I'm being very patient at the plate. You want to get him on first base any way you can. I mean, literally, I think I make him take right here.
Now, Army has put its leadoff hitter on in each of the last three innings.
Get your best hitter on deck and Rosoff.
Herterbees walks, and guess what he's going to do at first base? He's going to be off, even with a left-handed thrower. He is likely to challenge NC State again on the bases.
You know what I do right here? I leave him stay put. The threat of the steal is going to give Rosoff more fastballs. And you never know. You look at the hole between first and second base.
So in other words, you're not going to do what is the obvious.
Well, you're up four runs. Now, your mindset may change just a little bit. You got your best hitter up.
You could do a run and hit here.
Well, I think if you steal, they might pitch around him. I think you leave him at first base.
Rosoff has a nice hole between first and second.
Well, you can drive a bus through that hole. Look how big it is with the first baseman. Edwards having to hold the runner on.
And down the line, it would likely score Herterbees with little difficulty. Instead, he goes the opposite way to left field. Kinnaman handles one out.
Now you turn him loose.
I thought that was a very conservative approach on your part.
Sometimes you gotta change up what your normal approach is. But you know, I think you give Rosoff that opportunity to try to hit one through that big hole.
And hearing from your former teammate, Scott Pose, last night at dinner, I thought you were less conservative in nature, but let's see what happens here as Herterbees, who did not run the first time, goes back to first base on the toss over by Harrison.
Herterbees might get a one-way lead. That means going out there probably an extra step, going back to first base no matter what the approach is.
This one dropping in left field and caught on a diving catch by Kinnaman, who has two putouts in the inning. And now for the game has five.
Off the end of the bat, that ball just kind of hung up in the air, but Kinnaman, a really good read off the bat, made that play look easy. Hey, it's all about that first step in the outfield.
So Herterbees, who started the inning with a walk, remains at first with two outs. There he goes. They got him picked off, perhaps, and still he steals second base. This guy is something.
Yeah, he was safe. I mean, he was off to the races.
And now you know why he's the nation's best. Even when it appears he's in a world of hurt, he's able to steal second base.
Just a gigantic jump by Herterbees. The other thing he does well, he slides very hard and aggressive into a base. I mean, you just hope he never gets hurt, but, I mean, he goes in there flying full force.
Herterbees is now 42 of 48 in stolen base attempts. That's near 88%. Army with yet another man in scoring position with two outs. And this one, a wild pitch by Harrison. Herterbees around third. Is he going to try? No. But everybody here anticipated he would. Good hustle by Patrick Bailey and coverage by Harrison at home plate.
Well, I can tell you right now that I got up on the edge of my seat. Yeah. I literally sat up in the edge of my seat to see if he was going to take off. This ball is down and hits off the catcher's mask. He doesn't know initially where it's going. Good job by the pitcher to cover home plate. I think that's the right decision by Herterbees not to take that chance. Now another wild pitch is going to score a run.
Toward right field, dropping, in for a hit. Army leads 5-0. Anthony Jakeen comes through with two outs.
Well, Jakeen was the guy who could not get the bunt down earlier, or got it down and went right back to the pitcher. That ball is sinking on Deatherage. He knows he's got to try to make a play on that one. It just has too much topspin.
Now, people will argue and say, hey, this isn't small ball with a two-out scorched hit. But keep in mind, Herdebees walked, stole second, got to third on a wild pitch. That's Army style. Runner going. Pitch down and throw down to second base. Out. Bailey able to crack down on Jakeen and get him caught stealing. But Army adds to its lead. Time to get up and stretch as Army now has a 5-0 advantage. Prior to the Patriot League, the Army Black Knights leading NC State 5-0 in the last of the seventh. Brock Deatherage, Evan Edwards, Jack Conley scheduled to hit for the Wolfpack. So many reasons Army has a commanding lead. One of them stretches back to Giovinco not allowing a walk. And no runner has gotten past second base to this point for the Pack.
Well, the big thing for Giovinco, a couple key double plays that Black Knights have turned.
Yes, sir. High, towering pop-up in foul territory, now in fair. And handled easily by John McKenna.
I don't know if you categorize that as easily.
Maybe that was a stretch on words there.
He went from foul territory to fair territory. Made a great play, but that's just...
Okay, I'll take my word back.
That ball is an absolute moonshot. The second baseman, I think, right there almost has to call him off, but... Sometimes when a player's adamant about making that catch, you just let him go.
Yeah. Evan Edwards to the plate with a man out in the seventh. Going the opposite way. Down the left field line. Foul ball. Army, a run in the third, a run in the fourth, two in the sixth, one in the seventh. And Jim Foster hired to revive the Cadets program on the verge of a monster win in its opening game in the regional.
Well, if they got Tex just getting to this point, winning this ball game, I think his phone's going to blow up.
It deserves to.
You're going to get Tex from Generals.
Why not? It's a big story. Giovinco with the 1-1. How many times has he gotten ahead of hitters tonight?
Yeah, he's really pitched well. Moved the ball in and out. He is the true definition of a crafty lefty.
Doesn't throw particularly hard. Doesn't need to. In fact, to this point, has struck out just one.
I mean, that's the show me fastball right there. Throw it out of the zone. Wouldn't surprise me if he comes back a little soft breaking ball in the outside corner. I think that one caught a little too much of the plate.
Another factor in Giovinco's success tonight is the fact that he has not allowed an NC State leadoff hitter to reach except in the first inning. That's it. Again, the 2-2. Seven fly ball outs, nine ground outs, a strikeout to this point.
I think that's also the only one strikeout's help keep that pitch count down.
Toward left field, that's deep. He's got a chance. Off the wall. Evan Edwards into second base with a double. And this crowd, hungry for something big to happen, is applauding.
The ball really carries well to left. The wind is blowing out to left field. That ball travels deep. Evan Edwards drives it high off the wall. Good effort out there by Crompton. Just can't elevate high enough. Wolfpack down by five. They've got to start scratching out a few runs here and there.
Jack Conley's 0 for 2, grounding out twice to third baseman Jakeen. But a man in scoring position for the first time since the first inning for the Pack. From the stretch, 2-0. See any signs of him starting to tire?
Well, when you start getting the ball up in the strike zone, that's why Rosoff is going to go out there. The senior is going to talk to his left-handed pitcher. He's going to try to settle him down. That's also going to bring a visit from John Foster, the head coach, out to the mound.
88 pitches now in the game for Giovinco.
Foster, former catcher, he's going to go out there and talk. He understands what it means when a pitcher's going and maybe kind of pushing a little bit.
Cam Opp right now warming up for Jim Foster's team in the Army bullpen. And Foster's going to allow him a little time. Why not? But no reason to remove Giovinco to this point. So now you're Jack Conley. You have a 2-0 count. Is there a reason you swing here when you need base runners?
And my definition is you let him swing, but he better have a Pringle-sized strike zone. The size of a Pringles can. It better be the size of a baseball. If it's only in one spot, you swing.
Two and one, and he was taking all the way. And I don't think Conley liked the call.
He had a word of disgust to Ken Langford, the home plate umpire.
Now the 2-1. And Giovinco, after the mound discussions, battled back even.
I think he pulled the string right there with the straight change. Got it up in the zone a little bit, but off the end of the bat of Conley, just cued it. I can come back and throw another changeup right here.
Nobody's left the stadium yet. 3-2. You have to assume this is a big pitch for Giovinco, because if he loses him on a walk or a hit, that might be his night.
Well, I don't know. You got a left-hander on deck, so you might stick with the
go another
Giovinco.
Batter maybe, huh?
Possibly.
3-2 pitch. Lost him.
Yeah.
And for the first time since the very first inning, NC State's got two aboard.
And I thought he was going to go back to that changeup, trying to get Conley to chase. That was a really good at-bat by Jack Conley right there. You're wanting to produce in a big way as a hitter, and to be able to take that pitch is very disciplined.
Stephen Pateras flied out twice to right fielder Drake Titus. Two aboard, one out in the seventh, and a threat for NC State. JT Jarrett would follow, then the top of the order. Giovinco, ball one and up high.
Yeah, when you're starting to get a little bit tired, that curveball doesn't have the depth and the bite that it normally does, and that last one was very flat.
Patera making his 117th career start. Ball two and a good stop. by catcher Rozoff. And Rozoff's going to go out to the mound and possibly allow Cam Opp and others some more time in that pen. Miller checking toward the pen, among other things. 2-0 for Patera with two aboard and one out. NC State trying to roar back. Good pitch, 2-1. And he was taking all the way. Still a couple hitters away from getting the tying run to the plate. Up high again, 3-1. So now you're Stephen Patera. You fly out twice to right, but Giovinco is missing high.
Yeah, you got to make him work down in the strike zone. Again, that very, very small strike zone if you're even going to swing the bat in this situation.
Lost him. The bases are loaded. And that might be it for Giovinco. Who in the inning now has walked two. JT Jarrett is coming to the plate with the bases loaded. Still no movement, though, from skipper Jim Miller. As the pitch count is approaching 100, and now he will come out. And now Giovinco's night is done. He has thrown a shutout to this point, but NC State has got him loaded. And he's going to get a standing ovation for this Army contingent here, and why not? Sam Bacina, the right-hander, is in. Tyler Giovinco's night is done. Still has a chance to win it, though. Sam Bacina, the reliever, the right-hander, appearing in his 13th game, working 38.1 innings to this point. Bacina's from Phoenix, where his high school coach was also his dad, Sam.
Yeah, see the numbers on Bacina, the 4.23 ERA. Pretty good strikeout to walk ratio, 2-1. And the more strikeouts an innings pitch is always a good sign, but opponents are only hitting 229 off of Messina.
Elliot Avent is out to talk with the home plate umpire, Ken Langford. The scheduled hitter is Shane Shepard, who's a left-handed swinger.
JT Jarrett. I think Shepard is going to be the pinch hitter.
And they'll go with percentages here because Shepard is a left-handed swinger. We had a couple of hits against Virginia in the ACC tournament. Still a base runner away from bringing the tying run up. Army now to jam, and right now they'll play a double play depth to try to end the inning. Bases loaded, one out, bottom seven. Messina to the plate. Well, this threat started with the bottom of the order when Etheridge reached on a hit and back-to-back walks to Conley and Patera. Count even, a ball and a strike. Etheridge at third, Conley at second, Patera, the base runner, at first. Messina working from the stretch. Now ahead 1-2.
A really nice location by that last pitch by Messina, right under the hands of Shepard. Not letting him get those big arms extended. I like pitching inside right there, but the risk is a hit batter.
Best hitter in the ACC would be next. Towards center field, and Hernabees. NC State will get its first run of the game. And a runner from second advances to third. So the Wolfpack are on the board. It is now 5-1. But a huge out for Army as the ball was playable and catchable.
Yeah, I think you're Army. You're feeling pretty good about that situation. You're gladly trying to run for an out to try to avoid a big inning right here by the Wolfpack.
Josh McClain, center fielder for NC State, on the season with 87 hits. Batting average. Of Tyler G. Runners at first and at third. So let's get in ahead of Sam Messina. Two strikes and nothing. Are you wasting a pitch here?
I am, but I don't like the waste of the pitch that's, you know, 3 feet off the plate. You definitely don't want to make a mistake to a guy like Josh McClain, but you also you want to maybe entice him to possibly expand that strike zone. 6-8 inches. Not a bad time to maybe elevate, climb the ladder, and go up in the strike zone.
McClain, being the hitter that he is, does not chase. Ball and two strikes. Army will hold the base runner at first. They don't want to have a situation where there'll be two runners in scoring position.
I'm coming back with the breaking ball down and away, trying to get the strikeout.
And that one out of play.
Stick with the fastball. Good pitch, though.
Auburn awaits the winner tomorrow night, Northeastern against the loser of this game. Tomorrow afternoon. Once again, the 1-2. Two and two. Little drama there, huh?
Good check swing by McClain. So does the barrel go across home plate? No, good call. Morse Hodges, the first base umpire, got that one right. They usually do.
Inning over. Great relief job by Sam Messina. Gets a sacrifice fly out and a punch out. Coach's son over to shake his hand, and after seven, Army getting closer to an upset win. Wolfpack crowd seeing its heroes down 5-1 as we start the eighth inning. David Harrison is in his second inning of relief for NC State. Dylan Cooper is now the third baseman, and Stephen Patera moves from third to second defensively for NC State. Trey Martin will lead off. He has struck out. He has a sacrifice fly. He has singled and scored a run. Sam Messina coming up huge for Army as a relief pitcher. In the last of the seventh, entering with the bases loaded and just one out. Got a fly ball to center to score a run, then got a strikeout.
Yeah, that was big. You felt like that NC State had the opportunity right there to really kind of claw back into this ball game. Only scoring one run, Army will take that every day of the week with bases loaded with one out.
Trey Martin, Matt Hutchins, and Drake Titus, the scheduled hitters in the inning. Or rather, Rob Regina, who has replaced Matt Hutchins. And it was Regina that had the big pinch hit RBI double in the sixth. Martin toward first base. Pitcher trying to cover. Harrison throws and got him. What a play by David Harrison.
Okay, that's absolutely ridiculous. My first impression is let that ball roll foul. A backhanded flip by Harrison, the pitcher. And the only way he makes that play is he slides. He makes the perfect execution of how to play that ball, just a swing and bunt down the first base line.
Sports Center consideration?
Oh, absolutely. Got to love being able to feel the position off the bump.
Rob Regine, who showed plenty of emotion after that RBI double in the sixth inning. Now to play for the second time. Drake Titus would bat next. Looking ahead to the NC State eighth inning, back to the top of the order. And Josh McClain, Brett Kinnaman, and Will Wilson. Wolfpack will need many more to have a chance. Check that. McClain struck out to end the seventh inning. It'll be 2-3-4. Kinnaman, Wilson, and Patrick Bailey.
I think this is big right here for NC State to get through this inning. I don't think they need to let Army get any life right here.
And instead, Rob Regine is aboard for the second time tonight. Drake Titus now to the plate as a sacrifice fly to his resume this evening.
The right fielder, number 4, Drake Titus.
Well, 4 seeds beating 1 seeds in the regional, not unusual, but not often does it happen.
No, it doesn't. But you think about that walk right there. That's only the 4th walk allowed by Wolfpack pitchers. 2 have come around to score.
Yeah.
I was sitting there watching the scores flash across, and I swear I saw Florida State down 6-1.
It's the same Florida State that's in a regional tournament for the 41st consecutive year. Back in a moment.
Great play by the pitcher, Harrison. What an outstanding, that's a Sports Center highlight if you've ever seen one.
Time now for tonight's Capital One rewarding performance. It belongs to pinch hitter Rob Regine, who scorches an RBI double down the left field line in an inning which Army put 2 on the board. Those 2 runs are becoming more significant, providing a lot of cushion after NC State had scored 1 and had a couple aboard in the last of the 7th.
Matthew Gauthier on the mound right here. He's got a 4.17 ERA. He's got 41 innings pitched. Really good strikeout to walk ratio with 32 Ks and only 14 walks. Opponents only hitting 250 off the right-hander. But you talk about the pinch hit double by Regine. That was only his 26th at bat of the season.
And you had mentioned you thought that at that point Jim Miller had a hunch.
I can tell you right now that every head coach watches every swing and batting practice just for that very reason, just to see if a guy is showing him something that he hasn't in the past.
Toward first base. Got to put a tag on at second. Unsuccessful, even though a good effort was made. And so now runner in scoring position with 2 outs. And a ball hit hard by Drake Titus.
I still like the decision by Edwards. He's right on top of the base. He fields it. If he makes a good throw, the runner's out at second base. Watch how close he is to first base. That ball's on him in a hurry. He steps on the bag. If he makes a good throw, the runner's out at second. Easier said than done, because you have to throw around that base runner to get that ball into the shortstop's hands.
By the way, Matthew Gauthier is the fifth North Carolina State pitcher tonight. All began with Reed Johnston, who stands to lose this game unless the Wolfpack rally in the eighth and ninth innings.
That's trouble.
Watch the runner around third base. Heading to home plate. They're going to get him, though. Army tried that one too many times. And Regine cut down. On to the bottom of the eighth inning. Kinnaman, Wilson, Bailey. Due up for NC State. You know, Troy, it's not often we disagree, but I don't think Army should have attempted this.
Yeah, you know, they took a gamble right there. This play's not even close, but sometimes you want to force the defense to make a play. That's an easy throw and catch for Edwards to Bailey at home. I mean, he's out by 25 feet, but, you know, if the guy throws the ball to the backstop, you look like a genius if you're the third base coach. But, again, Army has lived and died on being aggressive, so that's their nature.
John McKenna is credited with a hit. Toward first base, another fine play by McKenna. One out. Army now five outs away from the victory.
Yeah, a couple balls torched at McKenna over there at first base, and he's made some pretty good stabs. I think a couple hit by Kinnaman.
Think back to how this game started for NC State, hitting the ball very strongly, but hitting into a shifted infield double play, then two scorched hits after that, leading to a strikeout that ended the first, and not until the seventh inning did the Wolfpack have another threat going. So really that first inning turned out to be huge. We saw in the Auburn game where Northeastern lost it in the very first. Didn't happen tonight for Army. And I don't know if you would call this a shift, as this one hit in the power alley will drop in for a single. McKenna was way off first base. Really didn't matter. As Will Wilson is on base for the third time tonight, he has three of NC State's eight hits.
Yeah, Will Wilson,
center field.
He's coming up big. He was our feature player of the ball game, and you can see why. Just very compact swing, not trying to do too much with that pitch. And anytime you see a hitter go the opposite field, that's a lot of trust in his hands and just letting that ball travel a little bit deeper into the strike zone. That's going to bring John Foster, the head coach of Army, out. He's going to make a pitching change. Again, sometimes you have a feel for a player. He had a feel for Messina.
So Jim Foster goes to the pen. Cam Opp comes on. And with that, we will take a break with Army still ahead by a score of 5-1. To the NBA Finals Sunday on ABC. Coverage starting with the NBA Countdown at 7:30. From the Oracle, and it's also streaming live on the ESPN app. The Warriors have a 1-0 lead. The latest word from the NBA is that Draymond Green should have been called for a lane violation before George Hill missed his second free throw. And on top of that, a report said Green should have been called for a foul with 12 seconds to go for grabbing LeBron James' arm. As you know, Golden State won it in overtime. Boy, if you're Cleveland, you're not feeling pretty good about that. Cam Opp's numbers, healthy. 23 appearances, ERA under 2.5, and 57.2 innings. Born and raised, London, England.
Yeah, opponent's only hitting 204 off the left-hander.
Facing Patrick Bailey, scorched towards center field. But Jacob Herdebees, automatic. Just like Drake Titus has been in right field, two outs. So quick work of Patrick Bailey.
Yeah, you can't hit the ball much harder than that if you're Patrick Bailey. You can't be disappointed if you're a NC State fan. You got a guy out there that takes a really good swing, puts a barrels up the baseball, and just right at the center fielder, Herdebees.
Pitcher Cam Opp tried to make the team at William & Mary as he was unsuccessful getting into the academy because he was from a foreign country. Special letter had to be written by, at that time, Vice President Joe Biden. So the letter was written, did not get to the academy
quickly
in time.
Enough, yeah. Mm-hmm. So he had to try to go to William and Mary, and then decided his heart was set to go to the academy, so he waited to the following year.
And another letter. Actually, the letter recommendation stood.
Right.
And then he got in, and here he is. A strike away from placing Army to the ninth with a 5-1 lead.
A really good-looking pitch right there. That's what you do on 0-2. Now, in the offseason, Op has developed a slider. He didn't have a very good off-speed pitch a season ago, but worked diligently at it this offseason. And
I like the way John Rosoff set up behind home plate on the pitch. Did he go around? No, sir. Two balls, two strikes on Brock Deatherage. Evan Edwards to follow.
I think if I'm Deatherage, I think I'm going to see another one of those sliders.
Place is quiet for the moment.
I tell you what I do right here if I'm Army. I play my first baseman, McKenna, right behind the runner.
Because the runner at first means nothing at this
point.
They're
up four runs. They want outs more than runs.
Agreed. Didn't matter on the change. Deatherage out on strikes. Cam up, comes in, does the job. Army now three outs away from a monster upset win in the first round of the regional. After eight, Black Knights 5, Wolfpack 1. Anthony Crompton set the lead off the Army ninth. In this game and to this point, he has struck out, sacrificed, and flown out. And back to the top of the order for the Black Knights.
You might see Crompton be very selective at the plate, maybe even take till he gets a strike. This leadoff batter is huge for the Wolfpack, and I'm really shocked he swung at that pitch.
Wolfpack have the bottom of its order scheduled to hit in the last of the night, 6, 7, and 8. Troy and Duke have picked up their game now after a long, lengthy rain delay, and Troy is leading 6-0. One out in the ninth.
This center fielder, number 39, Jacob Hurtubise.
Back to the top of the order, Jacob Hurtubise. He's been a terror on the base paths. He has stolen two bases. He advanced from second to home on an infield ground out. He has scored twice. Really seems to be, Troy, the heart and soul of this team. If he gets aboard, he is trouble.
He's electric on the bases, so you got to pound the strike zone with Hurtubise at the plate.
That is a foul ball. And, of course, home plate umpire Ken Langford will get a lot of grief because earlier in the game, and what the fans thought here was a foul ball when NC State was batting, turned into a fair ball and an out.
Well, this ball hits his bat twice. It hits off the bat. No, I thought it did. I'm not really sure what they thought that hit. Do they think it hit his foot? I mean, the plate's in fair territory if it hit the plate. That's a nuke loose fastball right there.
Yeah.
Bull Durham. Just a bit outside. See if this. Yeah, I think off the hop, it hopped off the ground and hit his leg.
Count reaches three balls and a strike. bottom of the order for the Wolfpack. Put together just two hits, both of them by Evan Edwards.
And not what you want to do is walk the nation's leading base stealer,
who on the season now has stolen 42 of 48, including the aforementioned two tonight. Winner of this regional will face the winner in Gainesville, Florida, after trailing 3-1, beat Columbia in opening round action today. Jacksonville 5, Florida Atlantic 3. It'll be Jacksonville, Florida tomorrow night. Earlier in the day, Florida Atlantic and Columbia in an elimination game. And I would think if this score holds up, the folks in Gainesville will be mightily surprised. NC State is listed as the 16th seed nationally, Florida as the number one seed. Toward short, just one play, that's first base. Herdebee's in a scoring position with two outs. And for Herdebee, scoring position means an infield grounder that goes 90 feet.
Yeah. He's one of those guys, if there was only one out and a deep fly ball, he might score from second.
Yeah. In fact, I thought when Herdebee's was on second base and there was a wild pitch and he was rounding third ready to come home, he got held up. But everybody here thought he might try to take two bases on that one. The outfield relatively shallow, and why not? Because on a hit, Herdebee's will fly.
Yeah, nobody's really holding him very close at second base. Patera now the second baseman. He's kind of shaded towards second base just a bit, but he's really not bluffing over there at all.
Think he'll try to swipe third?
No, he's going to stay put. With two outs, you cannot make that last out of third base.
Inning over. Herdebee stranded at second. Last chance for NC State as Army is on the threshold of a major first-round upset. NC State has lost four of its last five, two to Florida State. Then in the ACC tournament to Virginia and Florida State again. We'll need four to have a chance here in the ninth. Otherwise, they'll be approaching Northeastern tomorrow in an elimination game.
Well, the leadoff batter is huge for Army and for NC State as well, too. You've got to get that first guy, kind of sets the tone of the inning.
Evan Edwards, the leadoff, the last of the ninth.
Was Evan Edwards' last at bat? He doubled off the left center field wall. Started the rally that played the Wolfpack's only run.
Good start for Cam Opp, the left-handed thrower for Army, strike one.
Opp, like a lot of relievers, pitching solely out of the stretch right here. Some guys just feel more comfortable that way.
Several changes as Jakeen goes to first, White to third. Count 2-1. Clemson of the ACC has fallen behind in its game, 2-0 bottom of the third. Base hit left field. And NC State won't take any unnecessary chances here. That one scorched by Edwards, his third consecutive hit.
Great piece of hitting by Edwards. Again, his last two at-bats have been to the opposite field, a guy that's really sitting back and letting that ball travel into the strike zone again, you cannot make an out at second base right there when you're down by four. You got to play base to base, station to station.
One other substitution, Tim Samoes is now the second baseman. Strike called on Jack Conley. Conley's 0 for 2 and a walk. Not many people have left the park. But up, way ahead of Conley, nothing and two. Army three outs away from arguably the biggest win, biggest upset of the day. One out in the ninth.
Big pitch right there. Strikeout was huge, but if I'm Army, I still play behind the runner at first base. They're holding him on. They're up four runs. That run is irrelevant at this point. No, I don't play 50 feet behind him where the guy can just use give him second base. I literally play right behind the runner. If you're North Carolina State, you cannot afford to try to steal.
Stephen Patera at the plate. Takes a strike. All evening long, Army pitchers have gotten ahead of NC State batters. It was only in the seventh where back-to-back walks is really contrary to what they've been doing all night long. Not sure how that pitch missed, 1-1. NC State 1-for-10 with runners on base tonight. Kind of hit a scoring slump over the half dozen games the remainder of the season. Now 2-1. Still need a couple of base runners to get the tying run to the plate and turn this lineup over to this power hitting top of the order. In the meantime, a double play would end the game. And Army has turned two of them tonight.
Finally, the Black Knights play the first baseman behind the base runner at first base. I think that's the wise move right there. Get a left-handed batter up.
Agreed. Now the count runs to 3-1. Florida State now trending 6-5, bottom of the sixth to Samford. Runners down first and second. Army not out of the woods yet. And NC State not out of the game. So Devontae Brown from Noonan, Georgia, who once played for the home plate Chili Dogs, will step to the plate. It's a freshman, 5'11", 186. Devontae's job now is just to get on base.
Yeah, I think one, you want to try to get the righty-lefty matchup, and you also have a guy in Brown that's probably going to be very difficult to double up on a ground ball. Brown with only 24 at-bats, but we saw what happened with a guy with 25 at-bats pinch hit. Got to double down the line for Army.
Rob Regine. Strike called. Auburn awaits the winner, Northeastern the loser. The 0-1 to Brown. Nothing in two. That brings Elliot Avent out of the North Carolina State dugout, in which he'll talk to his hitter and probably get a few words into Ken Langford, the home plate umpire.
Yeah, those are a couple borderline fastballs.
Pretty good pitch.
That's not bad. I think that's a pretty good move by head coach Elliot Avan. I think he's just trying to break up the rhythm of the pitcher. I don't think he's saying anything that's going to help the batter in that situation, but sometimes pitching is all about rhythm, and you want to try to shake that up.
So Devontae Brown in a hole, nothing and two with a man out in the ninth. Two outs. Army and out away. And the cadet fans stationed along the third base dugout.
This interfielder, number 15, Josh McClain.
Left of home plate. A significant moment right now.
Well, you got your leading hitter in McClain at the plate, the guy that's kind of led this Wolfpack lineup all season long at the plate.
McClain has a terrific eye, so walk not out of the question either here. That would bring the tying run to the plate. Toward third base, this could end it. Game over, Army wins. Cinderella comes through in a stunning upset over NC State, 5-1.
Just an outstandingly played ball game by the Black Knights. Just picture perfect. They did the little things they needed to do, and an outstanding pitching job by Giovinco by the Black Knights to really shut down this Wolfpack lineup.
So NC State now goes to the elimination game versus Northeastern tomorrow. And surprise, surprise, the Cadets of Army of West Point are headed to the winner's bracket and a matchup with Auburn. Time now for our player of the game brought to you by Capital One. It is Tyler Giovinco. Pitched 6 1/3, allowed just an earned run, the only run that the Wolfpack had all night, and allowed 7 hits and did not walk anybody.
Yeah, he threw an absolute gem, and that's what a huge win for this Army program. And that's really put them on the radar nationally, I tell you. There's going to be a lot of people kind of scratching their heads about this one, but they played an outstanding ball game tonight.